Spartathlon. The mythical running race from Athens to Sparta, a distance of 246 kilometres that has to be covered in 36 hours. At the Phoenix Hotel in Glyfada the evening before the race, the athletes and their escorts are given their instructions. This is done in three languages: Greek, English, and French.
Μπαίνετε στο ζευγολατιό, εδώ είναι η εκκλησία και η πλατεία κλπ. Έτσι. Το checkpoint, ο δρόμος, ανεβαίνετε αυτό το δρόμο.
And we wish all of you that we have a very successful race and yourselves as well. First thing that I'd like to stress is the runners. Well, I'd like to welcome all of you to this year's running of the Spartathlon, the 31st Spartathlon race, continuously every...
Tomorrow, all roads will lead the Spartathlon. The origins of the race are to be found in Greek antiquity. In 490 BC, to be exact, when the Athenians sent Pheidippides, their long-distance runner, to Sparta to ask for military assistance. It was the time when the Persian Empire had attacked Athens, and she was now struggling for her very existence. The historian Herodotus wrote in his history that Pheidippides set off on foot and reached Sparta the following day. It was an unbelievable feat, so much so that historians considered that Herodotus was exaggerating. However, in 1982, a team of English long-distance runners, headed by John Fondon, managed to complete the distance in the same time, 2 days with 246 kilometres covered. Their names were John Salton, John Fonton, and John McCarthy. The race was born the following year. 45 athletes from 12 countries ran the first time. The winner was Yannis Koros, a phenomenal athlete. Koros managed four firsts in the same number of races, clocking up the four best times, unbeaten to this day. He became the modern legend of the Spartathlon. Acropolis of Athens, Theatre of Herodes Atticus. Dawn on Friday. ...322 participants from 35 countries. Everyone is here. Athletes, friends, relatives, supporters, organisers, and television cameras. The last commemorative photographs just before the start. The runners dominate the avenue in a city that has just woken up. For a while, the circulation of cars is of secondary importance. For 31 years now, on the last Friday in September, the contest has imposed its own rhythm on Athens. The checkpoint on the Hiera Odos, the sacred way. This is the first one in the race. The athletes have 74 similar checkpoints in front of them. The route of the Spartathlon roughly follows the ancient roads, and the first historical checkpoint is at Elefsina. This is where, in antiquity, the sacred way ended. Bustling Elefsina welcomes the runners, cheers from the children of the town in front of the archaeological site. Ancient Elefsina was a great religious centre and a sacred place for the Athenians. The old narrow road for Corinth follows the track of the old Skiron road. It runs along beside the sea.
58.
The narrow strait between the coast of Attica and the island of Salamis opposite makes an idyllic setting. The 246 kilometres to Sparta ascend to various heights, are subject to fluctuations in weather conditions, and of course the continuous pressure of time. The race must be completed within 36 hours. As time passes, the temperature rises and water becomes precious. The route passing outside the town Megara, with young schoolchildren from the town in the forefront. A little further on the road passes the impressive cliffs of Kakia Skala, the stones of Skiron to the ancient Greeks. In antiquity, the impenetrable cliffs gave rise to myths of the fearsome robbers, Skiron and Procrustes, reflecting the precariousness of the passage and the perils faced by wayfarers. At the checkpoints, volunteers and athletes move quickly with nervous energy. Water, isotonic drinks, refreshments and snacks are spread on tables. Most of the volunteers are old acquaintances of the athletes, since they have taken part for many years. This year, the introduction of ice cubes was naturally appreciated. Checkpoints come every 2 to 4 kilometres. The runners are recorded as they pass through. At 7 of them, the recording is done automatically by electronic means. This stage of the race is usually pleasant, since the runners are still fresh and the road isn't yet steep and difficult. Arrival at the Isthmus of Corinth. A little way past the bridge over the canal is the first central checkpoint. It is the entrance to the Peloponnese. The Isthmus is a landmark for the runners. Here they can get help from their escorts, a massage, a light meal, and a few moments of rest in the shade. At the entrance to the checkpoint is the corridor with the electronic recording of the athletes' times. The first part of the race ends here. The first 80 kilometres have been covered. Now it is midday and the run continues through the prefecture of Corinthia and its villages. Thank you. 2 p.m., the heat is intense. Now, the difficult part begins. The route through Carinthia is flanked by vineyards and orchards, picturesque villages and olive groves. The region is an important centre of wine production. Ancient Corinth. The course passes in front of the Agora, marketplace of the ancient city, and the Temple of Apollo. The temple is one of the monuments seen by Pheidippides when he came through here. Villa of the Snakes, seeking a little shade. Here, the checkpoint is manned by professors and officials of the Harhopio University of Athens. This year, I think that the first athletes arrived quite early. Of course, there was a long distance between each of the first 20 athletes. In general, the weather, which was very hot a few hours ago, has not helped up till now. But now things are a little better.
Bye-bye. Bon courage.
Merci.
In Assos, the welcome is with music. For most of the communities on the route, the Spartathlon is the event of the year.
Hey,
I am a supporter of athlete number 4, Ilias Kraiskos. I'm his brother and give him professional advice because I am a gym teacher. This is the first time I have taken part in a supporting role in such a big event as the Spartathlon, with its special historical importance. I am enthusiastic, and my brother, who has just come into checkpoint number 30, is taking part for the first time. Our goal is the pedestal of the statue of Leonidas in Sparta tomorrow afternoon. Everything's running smoothly. We haven't had any problems. No one appeared to be particularly tired. They all seem keen to continue. And we hope that they will reach the final post and at least will have had another great experience in their lives. The light fades as the athletes run through the Peloponnesian countryside. The darker it gets, the lonelier the race becomes. In the villages that have checkpoints, the villagers have gathered to meet the runners. In Chalkio, souvlakia are being grilled for the onlookers. Here we are at checkpoint 32. We are a group from another club that has organised a similar run, Ancient Nemea to Ancient Olympia, 180 kilometres. We always help at the Spartathlon. So far, things are going well. The checkpoint is fully equipped and we are waiting for the last athlete so that we can close at 9:15 p.m. Thank you. ancient Nemea. It is about the halfway point of the course. The small square is jam-packed. The strain is all too apparent on the athletes. Blankets, ointments and massage are called upon to relieve cramp, stiffness and swollen ankles. For some, this is the end of their attempt. A stomach problem, a mistake in tactics, something that did not go well. Up to now, around 80 people have come through the Nemea checkpoint, and so far, 40-odd have given up. I think that in the end, about 150 will finish, because the weather is very good and the athletes are in fine condition. The rest get ready for a great uphill and lonely run that will end at the Artemision mountain. There, following the ancient path, they will climb the mountain to a height of 1,160 metres before going down into Arcadia. Ancient Nemea was a sacred place for the performance of Pan-Hellenic Games. Points of light in a deserted, completely dark landscape. Here, the welcome takes on a new dimension. In the chill of evening, a cup of hot soup is worth a great deal. We are at the 38th checkpoint of the Super Marathon Spartathlon, and this is the 14th time I've been up here. The race seems fairly good compared with last year, when the temperature was very high and quite a few athletes were forced to give up. Up to now, all is going well, and I hope this will continue right up until the end. the square of Lykia. This checkpoint is considered basic. The escorts of the athletes and the volunteers await the arrival of the runners. Food and water, but also blankets, spare torches and camp beds for massage. Psychological and physical checkups for the runners. In the nearby steakhouses, interest in the race is combined with the souvlaki. The absolute darkness is pierced by camera flashes. Night brings coolness, but quite high humidity. The charge of the front runners towards Sparta continues all night long. At dawn, at 6:30 a.m., the Portuguese João Oliveira enters the city and finishes first with a time of 23 hours, 29 minutes and 8 seconds. Second, after daybreak, the German Rose Florian finishes in 25 hours, 29 minutes and 54 seconds. In third place, the Italian, Ivan Goudin, and the German, Stu Thoms, pass the finishing line after 25 hours, 54 minutes and 59 seconds. It is proof of the values that this contest represents, but also of the friendship between the two athletes. Picturesque Tegea was an important town in antiquity, as shown by the remains of the Temple of Alia Athena among the houses of the modern village. An example of the ancient glory of the town. Tegea on Saturday morning. The checkpoint at the Arkadian interchange. Review of the situation. Who are continuing? Who are giving up? How many are still to come through? As time passes, the runners face more difficulties in their efforts. Towards midday, the heat beats down on the athletes crossing Mount Parnon in Laconia. Fatigue and optimism. Sparta is only 50 kilometers away. In Laconia, the checkpoints are manned by local volunteers. The contest mobilises en masse the society of the area. From the experience we have gained during all these years at the checkpoints, we can say that this year's race is quite good, the organisation even better. It is improving as we ourselves improve. I consider that whoever has already crossed the mountain will certainly finish. The weather is a little warm, but it's favourable. We hope that next year we shall be here again along with the athletes. This means a great deal to us. It is a great honour, first of all, that athletes come from all over the world to pay tribute to our history. For us, as volunteers, it is very important that we can offer anything from a little water to rest and shade. This small offering is important for us.
πράγμα.
Thank you.
Merci.
The Memorial Monument to the 108. From here, the last stage of the route to Sparta begins. The checkpoint offers support all night long until the morning and is open for more than 14 hours. This year, the team of physiotherapists, as every year, was in action at all the checkpoints along the route. In the evening, there were no special problems. If we discount some cases of acute muscular cramp at Zevgolakio, and afterwards at the foot of the mountain and at Sangre. But fortunately, there were no injuries. We're heading towards the finish line now with those who continue. Some have remained in the race who are giving cause for concern, but we are here to deal with the situation with patience and are full of joy and respect for what they're doing. As you can see, the group of volunteers is growing, even the young ones. My small grandchildren who have grown up and come to take part in this whole enthusiastic situation. The village of Vodiani, on the outskirts of Sparta. The city can be seen in the distance, 10 kilometers further on. Tiredness and humor. The statue of Leonidas in Sparta, the king symbol of the city. From midday on, many more athletes reach the finishing line. It is calculated that when the first runner passes the winning post in Sparta, the last one is still in Arcadia. The mobile unit of the Sparta hospital and its personnel in action. Preventative medicine and the treating of inflammation. Satisfaction, but also problems with feet. The Spartathlon challenges the limits of human endurance. Mental strength makes up for bodily limitations. ...36 hours on the road in changing weather conditions, temperature and humidity, mountain roads, paths and mountain passes. Great differences in altitude. Unimaginable strain on the human body, especially the legs. A race that has as its only prize a little water from the river Evrotis and an olive wreath. A Herculean labour for an idea. A hymn to the human will, to to the values of humanism, to the Olympic ideal, to friendship and solidarity. A feat accomplished in front of the statue of Leonidas. The athletes of the Spartathlon finish the race. Extreme tiredness mixed with joy, excitement and enthusiasm. Here, the order in which they come in and the time have almost no importance. The essential thing is finishing. Moving, personal and family moments. Sparta has cause for a double celebration. Two of her children, Stella Makarku and Christos Mazouras, will manage to finish. In total, 148 runners completed the course, and of these, the largest percentage was achieved by the 21 Greeks who finished. The race exerts a powerful fascination. It is, perhaps, the most difficult long-distance race in the world and is based on historical precedent. Many athletes return almost every year to repeat Pheidippides' achievement. The 21 times that the Finn Ari Mustala has taken part, the 10 times of the Pole Svitniek Malinowski, and the age of the 60-year-old Japanese Yoshikochi Osama stand out, as also does the achievement of Angel Palaruelo, who, at the age of just 20, finished alongside his 50-year-old father, Gilles Palaruelo, an old hand at the Spartathlon. In the evening, Sparta honours the Spartathlon athletes with the award of prizes. The first three men are honoured, and also the first three women. The Hungarians, Sylvia Lubitz, and the Germans, Angie Kraus and Heike Berkman. The Japanese team kept up the tradition by sending the most athletes to take part in the race. I welcome you, athletes, of the 31st Spartathlon to Athens, the host city of the 2004 Olympic Games. I congratulate you on your successes and for your very good results, and I thank you all for your participation in this year's race, where the number of athletes who completed the course was exactly double what it was last year. I assure you that the Administrative Council of the Spartathlon worked hard for a whole year to organize such a large, complicated project, one that now demands professional expertise, the use of modern methods, and the commitment of much time, effort, and funds. All those requirements have been satisfied, and our resources have been given willingly for the Spartathlon, because we are enthusiastic and persuaded that such an important event deserves a great deal of time being given up to it. I thank you all for honoring us with your presence, and to the athletes, I wish a safe return to their countries and health, personal and family happiness, and sound preparations for the next Spartathlon. Another Spartathlon has come to an end. At the reception of the association in Athens, after the commemorative medals, there is time for relaxation and amusement. We shall meet again at the Spartathlon of 2014.
Κύριο Σελκανιώτης για την απονομή. From Austria, Frank Hosits from Austria.
We are now at the end of this Spartathlon. This evening we have the award of the trophies. The weather for this year's race was much better than last year's. It was not so hot. And I think that this year the organization was the best so far. Little by little we are becoming wiser and learning from past experience. We're very pleased. The athletes made it a fine contest. They truly gave their all and can now leave in a warm glow of satisfaction from Greece, the race, the Spartathlon. It is known internationally that the Spartathlon is not for everyone, being suited only to a few. I wanted to be one of those few, and that's why I came and ran in the race. I have been enthusiastic about it since I first took part in 2009. This year, I'm particularly grateful to people like Lucas, who helped me a lot. I want to give my warmest thanks to the organizers of the Spartathlon.
Este ano, a organização apoiou-me totalmente. Eu acho que a vitória que eu tive hoje é graças ao pessoal da organização, ao filho do presidente e ao amigo dele da Press, que me ajudou muito em tempos de conhecimento de tempos. Só tenho que dizer, agradecer, muito obrigado à organização do Spartathlon.
I have experienced the race, the Spartathlon, once more as an event unlike any other. After taking part 11 years running, I am convinced that this race is absolutely unique. Each time you feel it under your skin, in your soul, your heart, that it is unique. Every time I've taken part and finished the course, believe me, the joy is unique, whether it was the first time or this year. A huge thank you once more to all who spent so many hours as volunteers helping so that the organization would be as successful as it was, and to the supporters of the team so that they could help their athletes.
Να βοηθήσουν έτσι ώστε η διοργάνωση να πάει όπως πήγε, τόσο καλά, και στους ανθρώπους, τους υποστηρικτές των πληρωμάτων, για να βοηθήσουν τους αθλητές τους.
When I first started taking part in long-distance running races, I heard about the Spartathlon. It's widely known in Hungary because many of our athletes have come here and completed the course. For the Hungarians, the Spartathlon has a special atmosphere, very good organization, and the Greeks are wonderful. It is therefore well worth the trouble for someone to prepare for this. For these reasons, it is for me both difficult and easy to be here for the race.
Az itteni embereknek a kedvessége, a közvetlensége is Maga a verseny nehézsége, ami évről évre egy kihívást tud biztosítani számomra, mert elég nehéz ahhoz, hogy egy hosszú tréninget, egy nagyon nehéz tréninget végigcsináljak ezért.
The Spartathlon is a legend, the revival of a great story, the embodiment of an idea, the divinely inspired joy of glory. It's a sensational experience, and we shall repeat it every year if we can. I am happy. I am pleased and proud that for 28 years I have been taking part in this service. Next year, we shall be here again to help with the Spartathlon. We come here every year and invest our heart and souls into it. It is a great honor to be able to offer a glass of water to an athlete who is doing this.